action from Spradling International Field. Today's game is hosted by the Rhino. They'll be defending against the Legend. I'm Dan Stevens, and joining me is my good friend, Peter O'Keefe. Let's take a look at today's All-Pro lineups, Peter.
John Elway and Jerry Rice set the tone for the Legends. Don't look now, but your TV is about to melt, folks. There's no way to contain this kind of offensive firepower that's soon to be on display. But they're not the only team featuring superstars. Troy Aikman and Gale Sayers lead the charge for the Rhinos. You know, it must be nice for a coach to have this kind of talent out of the backfield. These guys are going to put on one heck of a show, I'll tell you that.
All right, Peter, thanks. Now let's go down to the coin toss.
Hey, franchise, here we go.
Gentlemen, please make your call.
We pick tails.
Tails it is.
We want the ball.
The Legends have won the toss and select to receive.
Sader boots it downfield, and we're underway. Woodson decides to take it out of the end zone. Dragged down at the 23.
Rod Woodson got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Legends will begin the drive at their own 23-yard line. Sanders takes this one way out left and moves forward for seven.
Sanders with the pick. Gain of seven on the play. Wood with the tackle. Second and three.
Gains 8 yards, and that will bring up first down. First down, tight end to the left.
First and 10 from the Legend, 38 down.
Just barely passed the markers for a first.
10 yards on the play. First down, Legends. First and 10.
Watch out for the play action!
Ball at the 48-yard line.
Sanders takes it off the toss and passes the line. Back down at the 47.
Barry Sanders got some help on that one in the form of blocking, but he still couldn't make a play out of it.
Not a lot of room on that play. It will be third down. Third down, one man back. Elway throws a heater right sideline, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Dwight Frazier couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
Peter, the defense stood tall and forced the incompletion, but I don't understand that call. They wouldn't have gotten much at all, even if it was complete.
Fourth down either way, and in my opinion, too, a bad call.
Hammett
gets ready to punt it away. The snap and punts it away. Let the punt bounce for a touchback.
Devin Hammett saw his kick go squirrely on him for a touchback. Tough luck.
Everybody ready? It's gonna be double week stretch. Break.
The Rhinos will start the drive at their own 20-yard line. Sayers has his number called on first down and chews up about four on the play.
With a carry. Gain of 4 yards on the play. Singletary with the tackle.
Second down from the shotgun.
Second and six. Ball at the 24-yard.
Spellman. Jackson way back at the 16.
Loss of 8 yards on the play.
Dwayne Spellman forced the offense back a few yards with a terrific sack in the backfield.
They read that play the whole way, and they force a third and very long.
Monstrous D the past few downs for these guys.
Aikman throws a beauty to the right side.
Sean Powers is going to make the catch right there, but that's only the beginning. Look at him chew up the yardage.
Peter, what a fantastic play. Well, I tell you, it looks like there's more than one way to make the chain gang get some exercise.
And let me tell you, they could use it. Come on, fellas, put a little sprint in your step.
First and ten.
Second carry and chews up about four on the play. Burley had to leave the field earlier in the game, and now we've gotten word on his condition. Peter?
Apparently the team doctors have said that he is suffering from a hyperextended elbow. They're trying to mitigate the pain by taping him up, but it doesn't seem to be working. They're listing his return as doubtful.
Well, we'll hope for the best. Thanks, Peter. Second down, three wideouts in the game.
Sayers just flies over the defense on this one. I didn't even see him take off. That was some big air he caught. What a hurdle.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chain.
Great execution.
Sayers has his number called on second down and will end up losing a bunch here.
Tackle made by Woodson. No gain on the play. Third and goal from the legend, 8-1.
Number 32, the penalty is declined.
That's the first score of the game, and it was very nicely done, Peter.
Great execution there.
Sater is back for the point after. Ware will hold the kick.
The point after, and it's good.
Don't get down, guys. This is nothing. Nothing. When we get the lead, let's get back out there and crack some heads.
Sater kicks it off.
Todd Woodson took it out of the end zone. While it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20. So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Legends had their last drive stall at the tail end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 21-yard line. Sanders carries it past scrimmage and picks up a couple.
Barry Sanders had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were hoping for more. Jerry Rice goes to the outside here and picks up some good yardage. It's worth a second look. Nice gain, past the marker, and out of bounds. That's a great play.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
Great execution.
First and 10. 34 yards.
Throws a big here, and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
John Elway found a hole in the defense. Let's look at this again, because this is what you need out of your passer. Oh, he sees the opportunity and drives the ball home. His first huge connection of the day was 2 inches from the sun, I swear.
All right, settle down. Slight exaggeration there, big guy. All right, that was a big play. This defense better watch themselves. A line has just been drawn. Sanders carries it for the sixth time and gains about 3 yards.
Second and 6.
Play it, Sanders gets the call again and gets the first and more. Touchdown!
Barry Sanders sticks close to his blockers here. And it pays off.
Peter, that will put a touchdown in his stat column.
And that's always nice to have him. And so far, he's got 54 yards and one touchdown.
Nedney is back for the point after. Bevan will hold the kick.
The extra point, and it's good. Nedney crushes this one deep. Sayers decides to take it out of the end zone. And gets free. Stopped at the 23.
Bill Sayers took it out of the end zone. And while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20. So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Rhinos had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 23-yard line. Langston makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Zen Langston cuts in there and gets himself in a perfect spot.
Absolutely, Peter. He's able to keep the receiver from getting near it.
Well, the closer you play, the better your shot is at breaking up the completion.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up.
Second and 10 from Royal Rhino, 23 yards.
For about five. Third down, 5 yards to go. First on third and long.
Troy Aikman makes a terrific completion in double coverage here.
Wow.
Now that is one confident QB.
Nice pass, Peter, and he's really lighting up the stat sheet.
Oh, you got it. So far, he's got 86 yards and one touchdown.
Throws to Peter, and he's on target for a gain of five.
Jamie Lyman had a defender close by, but was able to bring down the catch.
They move the ball, and it will be second down.
Second and five.
Sayers pitches it in the flat, and that will be a gain of 3 yards.
Bill Sayers had nobody on him. The quarterback saw it and got the ball to him.
A decent play, and they'll now face third and short.
That's the key, Dan. Make third down easy, and they did just that.
Now they just need to convert. We'll see what they do.
Keep it up.
the 49.
Fourth down coming up.
Fred Coleman is not going to let them get back to the line here. Look how he just rolls into the backfield and just lays out the ball carrier. He's quick and he knows how to hurt a guy.
They came up big, caused the loss of yards, and more important, forced the fourth down. What a play by this defense.
You said it, Dano. They're all fired up down there.
Filipovic gets ready to punt it away. Filipovic takes the snap and punts it away. The Legends let the punt bounce out of the end zone for a touchback.
Tim Filipovic saw his kick go squirrely on him, flying out of the end zone for a touchback. Tough luck.
The Legends got into the end zone last time they had it, and they're looking to do it again. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. On the plate. Let's listen to the call.
Neutral zone infraction. Number 93, defense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat, first down.
Michael Lane was lined up on the ball and the ref called him on it. That's a neutral zone infraction.
First down from the on.
First and from the Legend, 25 yards.
Picks up a couple.
Barry Sanders used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not a lot of room. Second down.
Right. Second and three.
Be denied and drop them for a huge loss. Big play.
They don't let that play get back to the line of scrimmage, and that will bring up third down. Dodgers the right side, and they convert on third down.
A pickup of 14 yards on the play. First down, Legends.
Michael Dawkins gets there to reel in the catch despite being double covered. What do you have to do to intimidate this guy? Well, he never takes his eye off the ball, Dan, even as he's bracing for the hit.
A nice gain, and they easily convert on third down.
Yeah, that was a good call.
First down with the tight end, White. Up 4 yards, and that brings up second down.
He picks up 4 yards on the play, covered with the tackle. Second and six. Ball at 34 yards.
Fastball over the middle and somehow holds on to it for the first down.
First down, Legends.
You guys ain't got game. Baby.
First and 10. From Carolina, 27 yards.
Yeah. Second down, and this is the seventh play of the drive.
Gets the sack way back at the 50.
Michael Lane got a nice sack in the backfield that sent this offense backpedaling. Spin class? That's funny. As if I still work out.
They forced that one backwards, and that's going to make this third down that much harder.
Yeah, they also make it easier on themselves by wiping out all of the potential short yardage plays they might face.
Third and long. And that'll do it for quarter number one, and we're all tied.
We need more out of you. Where you been today?
Don't worry, man. I'm gonna get it turned around.
Cooper will be credited with the tackle. It'll be fourth down.
Tracy Cooper chases his man down and gets him before the marker. It's worth another look. Yep, he let some yards get by, but he made the stop when he had to.
That's his third tackle of the game. Fourth down, and they're going for it. The Legends want to talk it over, and they take their first timeout. Fourth down and less than a yard. Nedney launches the 54-yard attempt, and they take the lead.
Chris Nedney really gets the whole ball here, and he needed it. Watch. That's a powerful kick for 3 points, my friend. When he needs to, he can boot that thing.
Nedney boots the heck out of this one. Sayers downs it for a touchback. The Rhinos stalled early last drive. We'll have to see what happens here. We'll start at their own 20-yard line. Up 4 yards, and that brings up second down.
Second and six. Ball at the 24-yard.
Sayers gets the call again, and almost gets back to the line of scrimmage, but not quite before he's taken down.
Number 68 would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long. Coverage incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Daron Hurd gets a hand on this one. Right there. That's how you play D.
How about blocking this thing? Come on, let's swarm this guy.
Filipovic lines up to punt after the three and out.
Woodson is deep to receive.
Filipovic gets the ball and hits a beauty. Woodson fields the punt.
Rod Woodson returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
The Legends will start a drive with the lead for the first time this game. We'll begin at their 41-yard line. Rice picks up the Hebrew left sideline, and that's a gain of 7 on the play.
Jerry Rice had nobody on him. The quarterback saw it and got the ball to him.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Second down, and they line up with three tight ends. Elway gets all of his arm into this pass, and it's complete for the first down and a whole lot more.
First down, Legends.
John Elway throws right past the coverage and into his receiver's hands. Nice throw.
What a pass, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 115 yards and no interceptions.
Down.
The entire offense clicked on that play, Dan. Big yards from the runner because he knew where he was going at all times.
What a run, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, yeah, he's running hard. And up to now, he's got 72 yards on 12 carries.
First and 10.
We'll get the carry on first down. Miss the field. Back down at the 17.
Sanders with the carry. Gain of 8 yards on the play. Banks credited with the tackle.
Don't buy that play action fake.
And that will bring up first down.
Whoo! You on fire, man.
Just out here grinding away like I always do.
First and 10.
Touch the man.
Sanders quick to hand off and chews up about four on the play.
Sanders with the pick. Gain of 4 yards on the play. Hampton with the tackle. Second and six. Ball at the 8 yard line.
Clark snags the dart right sideline, and that's good for six.
Dwight Clark had to head out of bounds short of the first, and as we all know, it doesn't count if you keep running once you're out of bounds.
A decent play, and they'll now face third and short.
That's the key, Dan. Make third down easy, and they did just that.
Now they just need to convert. We'll see what they do.
Well, the defense has its hands full, Dan. Do they protect against the run or try to neutralize this passing threat?
Calls him down in the backfield, and that takes them even farther away from the marker.
Fourth down coming up.
Corey Young read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They come up with the big play, and on third and short, they force the fourth down.
Yeah, they even caused a loss of yardage. What a time to come up big.
Nedney from 20 yards, and he knocks it through the uprights.
Chris Nedney has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
Rushes this one deep.
Sayers
is coming out with it.
At the 24.
Will Sayers looking out of the end zone. And while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20. So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Rhinos take the field, and their running game hasn't generated much other than a big play here or there. We'll see how they fare as we start at their own 24-yard line. Sayers gains 5 on the play, and that brings up second down.
Five on the play. Number 58, credited with the tackle. Second and four from Will Rhino, 29 yards.
Sanders gets the call on second down. Stop at the 34. That will bring up first down. Chews up 9 yards, and that will bring up second down.
Gale Sayers baffles the D on this one with his magic feet. Check it out. It was some juke, Danny. Totally caught the defense off guard.
He gets another call, and he's carried the offense on his shoulders for these last three plays.
Hey, until it stops working, there's no reason to look elsewhere.
Second down, 1 yard to go. The toss and picks up the first down.
First down, Rhino. First and 10. What do you go?
Yeah! the 46.
Mike Singletary got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
That's his third tackle of the game.
Second and 11 from Roy Rhino, 46 yards.
Aikman throws a heater right sideline and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Rex Williams couldn't get all the way positioned for the interception, but still managed to graze the ball with his fingertips.
That'll give us a third down, and the defense was ready for that call.
Well played, and a good job of not giving up the short pass.
Third down and four wideouts in the game.
36 yards.
Shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
Here they connect with him again. That's the second deep ball he's grabbed today.
Well, without an adjustment in that secondary, Dan, I guarantee you he's going to come back for more.
A bullet to the flat, and the ball's caught. Eventually pushed out of bounds at the 15.
Oh, we got you back in the field. We ain't gonna stop.
First down, Rhino.
Is this a great drive or what?
From the legend, 15 yards.
Short loss.
Dwayne Spellman would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Right. Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down.
Spot where he could put the football, Dan, and that's right where it goes.
Now watch how he sneaks this ball past multiple defenders.
Yeah, it takes a considerable amount of poise and confidence to execute a play like this.
You know, I love what this passing scheme accomplishes, game in and game out.
We're seeing the steam coming from this offensive engine big time. They're looking hard to stop. Dominant pass, dominant run, a lot of firepower on the field.
Loses two, and that brings up second down.
Mike Singletary would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
They halt this play behind the line of scrimmage, and that will bring up a second down.
Second and goal.
Zen Langston would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
Another good stop by the defense, and that will be two losses in a row.
Third and goal from the legend, 6 yards.
It's intercepted. Ellard tackles him for a touchback.
Woodson.
Big pick, baby! Big pick!
Rod Woodson picks off the pass because he plays the zone so well here, completely snookering the quarterback. That's just how you do it, folks. You can't coach that.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Legends came away with three last time out and are looking for more. They'll start this drive at their own 20-yard line.
Barry Sanders makes a great run here, but the design run is far from foolproof.
It's risky, but it's a lot easier when you've got such great blocking up front.
Yeah, you don't want your quarterback smashing and bashing for yards. You want him to have a smooth ride all the way.
That's yet another run for him. He's definitely getting a workout so far.
They're relying very heavily on their running game, and so far, I can't blame them.
Is it down the left side? And it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Gain of 30 yards on the play. First down.
Jerry Rice faces double coverage, but nothing seems to faze this guy. Great move to get open. Well, the defense had him blanketed, but he's the only one that made a play on the ball.
He explodes out of the gate with a number of catches. This guy, well, he's just a consistently good player, Peter.
Absolutely, Dan. Really impressive communication with his quarterback. Tracy Cooper read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
Peter, he's been lighting up the defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got 6 tackles.
Big stop, baby. Great tackle.
Oh, yeah. I'm feeling good now.
Throws a ball, interceptions made at the 37, tackled, and the clock will continue to run. Third down and less than a yard. Six. Flag down on the play. Let's get the call.
Neutral zone infraction. Number 93. Defense. The penalty is declined.
Dan, watch this play unfold. These guys are so talented. It's really just amazing to sit back and watch them take care of business. Oh, and I'll tell you what, he takes care of business throughout this play. Makes me want to hit the gym again and maybe, you know, get back down there on the field.
We're going with double weak stretch. Break.
Break.
First and goal. Ball at 6 yards.
Sanders takes it for his 20th carry and gets the touchdown.
Sanders,
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
That was his second rushing touchdown of the day. Not a bad day at the office so far.
That's typical production for him, Dan. He's that kind of player.
Nedney is back for the point after. Bevin on the hold.
Here's the extra point, and it's good.
The point is good.
Nedney crushes this one deep. Sayers downs it for a touchback. The Rhinos can climb back into it with a score before the half here. They'll start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Clock will continue to run.
Spellman credited with the tackle. Loss of 3 on the play.
All right, big play. Let's do it again. Oh, yeah. I hope they come at us the same way.
Second and 13. Ball at the 17-yard line.
Goes right up the middle and heads left. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run.
Will Sayers played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
Nice gain, and that puts them in a very convertible third down situation.
Yeah, you know, Dan, my last convertible was a 72 Nova.
You know, Peter, it's no wonder you were a lineman. Third down, two wideouts on the field. Langston makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. That will bring up fourth down.
Zen Langston came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That was the fourth time they've swatted the ball out of the air, and the offense is looking frustrated.
The D is showing excellent fundamentals right here.
Filipovic gets ready to punt it away. Filipovic gets the ball and punts it away. Woodson takes it at the 30. Dragged down at the 33.
That ain't gonna cut it against our coverage, baby.
And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Legends enjoying the lead 20-7.
Okay, Dan, let's get this halftime show started. What do you have for us?
Well, here's a look at our halftime stats, and as you can see, it paints a pretty clear picture. The Legends are winning because of it. Let's see if they can keep up their dominance in the second half. Let's get started in this one early in the first quarter. Powers came up with a huge play here as they cover a lot of real estate on this one. A 58-yard play that set up a home team touchdown. The Rhinos strike first and go up by 7. Trying to answer back, the Legends have the ball at the 29. Sanders is going to bounce this one to the outside, and look at the execution up front. And he's in the clear. A 29-yard touchdown for the visitors. Midway through the first, game tied, 7-all. Aikman went to the air, trying to convert on third down, and he found his man. The Legends, now in the second quarter, Nedney is going to try to dial one in from very long distance.
Plenty of leg to it, though. He's got it. A 54-yard field goal. The Legends up 10-7. Elway would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. That set up an automatic 21-yard field goal. The Rhinos, late in the second quarter, the ball at the 7-yard line. Woodson was in the right place at the right time as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. Still late in the second quarter, the Legends winning by 6. Sanders got the call on third down and it paid off. And that will do it. The Rhinos are down at the half 20-7.
Nice job, Dan.
The Rhinos get the ball first this half and they could use a score right out of the gates to get back into this one. They currently trail 20-7. Now let's get to the game. Sends it away to begin the second half. Sayers bounces it for a touchdown. The Rhinos must feel like they need to score this time out. This drive will start at their own 20-yard line. At the 19.
LeVar Pack read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
That's his second tackle so far.
Second and 11 from Roy Rhino, 19 yards.
Sayers gets the call again and passes the line. Stop at the 23.
Sayers with the pick. The pickup of 4 yards on the play. Singletary credited with the tackle. Third and 7. Ball at the 23 yards.
Away right at the line.
Yet another big play by this defense. That was their fifth batted ball today.
Yeah, you can see them start to anticipate the path of the throw the minute the quarterback winds up.
Hey!
Roy Rhino has selected the punt. Woodson is deep to receive.
Filipovic gets the snap and hits a beauty. Woodson fields the deep punt at the 31. Back down at the 36.
Rod Woodson got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Legends come out on offense, and they are well ahead. They'll start this drive at their 36-yard line. Elway zips it to the left sideline, and it's complete at the 42, eventually shoved out at the 48. It will be first down.
First down, Legends.
Willie Wood finally makes the play, but not in time. Let's have another look. Oh, yeah, gave up a lot of yards before forcing him out of bounds.
The defense gives up the first down pretty quickly there, Peter.
Yeah, you got to at least slow him down a bit.
First and 10.
Sanders is at the 35, 20, Sanders hangs on.
will bring up first down.
Dan, this is really a tremendous run here. It all starts with getting up to speed extremely fast before the D can really get it together.
The blocking helps him get a little momentum going, and then he's smart enough to make the right running choices downfield.
Oh, he's so dangerous when he busts loose like that. A highlight reel play.
Nice run, Peter, and he's putting together some very nice stats.
Definitely. Up to now, he's got 167 yards on 21 carries.
But got rid of it just in time.
That falls incomplete, but it would have been a minimal gain had they completed it anyway.
Let's go!
Second and ten.
Catches it in the flat, and is at the 15, at the 13.
Barry Sanders used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Elway throws this on a low. It falls incomplete.
No points here. We're going to bust through the line and block this kick.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Four on the play clock. It's off! The Rhinos take the field and have a chance to capitalize on the block. Will start at their own 24-yard line. Aikman passes this one, and it's incomplete.
Sean Powers looked like he was all over that one, but it just got away somehow. Tough incompletion.
Potential for a quick first down, but no, they cannot hook up the pass.
You can take a shot in that situation, and it's really not going to hurt you. That's a good call.
That'll bring up second down.
Second and ten. Ball at the 24 yard.
Make a great play right here. Snags the football and then really turns on the juice.
This is a take no prisoners kind of guy when he is in the red zone.
Oh, after piling up some good yardage on the day, he makes a big play here for a score.
The point after, and it's good.
Let's go.
comes one downfield. Woodson is coming out with it. This is a tackle. Tackled at the 20.
Rod Woodson took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Legends take the field and will start out at their own 20-yard line. Up second down.
Michael Wilson got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
Peter, he's been lighting up the defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got 7 tackles.
As well, past the markers for a first down. We have a penalty marker on the play. Let's get the call from the field.
Late hit, number 57, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Tracy Cooper tackles his man on this play well after the whistle blew. Watch this again. Oh, yeah, clear-cut case of unnecessary roughness.
Thanks for giving me all that time, boys. That's why us boys in the trenches get paid the big bucks, right?
Hey! First and 10. The Legend, 50 yards.
Rifles it out the left side, and the reception is made for a pickup of maybe a yard.
Second.
You be ready out there. You hear me?
Legends, 49 yarder.
Clark catches it in the flat and loses yards on that one.
Mike Clark lost yards on that play back there. You got to get some yards before you can run out of bounds, fella.
No forward progress on that play, and that will bring up a third and long.
You ain't playing like yourself today. We need to pick it up.
I need some help out here, man. I can't do it all myself.
This one over the middle. The reception's made at the 36. Finally stopped at the 27.
2 yards on the play. First down, Legends.
Jerry Rice makes the catch, but that's not enough for him. He gets it and takes off for more.
This guy has been pretty much unstoppable this contest. You might think you have him covered, but you don't.
That's absolutely right, Dan. Solid effort from whistle to whistle. If the D doesn't step up now, they might not get a chance later on.
The man catches it over the middle and is at the 20. And he stopped right there.
They only need a couple here.
So let's buckle down, guys.
Let's go. Second and one.
On the play, and that brings up first down.
Oh.
Barry Sanders baffles the D on this one with his magic feet. Check it out. It was some juke, Danny. Totally caught the defense off guard.
What a run, Peter, and his numbers are adding up.
Adding up to one big number. Up to now, he's got 177 yards on 23 carries.
First down, goal to go.
This is where we stop him.
Physical.
Second and goal. Ball at the 3 yard.
Elway loops this one to the end zone, and it's caught for the score.
Pass complete to Dawkins.
Baby. Woo!
John Elway launches this one perfectly, and the D was nowhere to be found.
You got that right. Missed coverage all around.
That's right, Dan. My 6-year-old could have covered that pass better.
Peter, that's his first touchdown pass of the game. How do his stats look?
Well, so far, he's got 238 yards and one touchdown.
Here's the point after, and it's good.
The extra point is good.
Me boots the heck out of this one. Sayers decides to take it out of the end zone. Great screen. Stop at the 24.
Dale Sayers took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Rhinos will start this drive at their own 24-yard line. Up a couple.
Dale Sayers had some blocking help on that last one, but he was still left with nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were kind of hoping for more.
Second and 8 from Lower Rhino, 26 yards.
Losing a couple.
Number 68 read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
That's his third tackle of the game.
Third and 10 from Orlando, 24 yards.
On third and long.
Ryan Pearson gets there to reel in the catch despite being double covered. Well, what do you have to do to intimidate this guy? Well, he never takes his eye off the ball, Dan, even as he's bracing for the hit.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
Brings up second down.
Mike Singletary read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
Peter, he's been lighting up the defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got 7 tackles.
Sayers has his number called.
Bill Sayers played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
Nice gain, and that puts them in a very convertible third down situation.
Yeah, you know, Dan, my last convertible was a 72 Nova.
You know, Peter, it's no wonder you were a lineman. Them even farther away from the marker. It'll be fourth down.
Mike Singletary targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
He's been working hard so far. That's his 8th tackle.
And each one of those 8 left a bruise. That guy can hit.
Filipovic gets ready to punt it away.
Filipovic takes the long snap and punts it away. Woodson fields the punt at the 14. Back down at the 19.
Ball is spotted at the 19-yard line.
We're right where we want to be in this game. Let's keep plugging away.
Let's go.
First and 10. From the legend, 19-yard line.
It looks like we have an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you.
Tracy Cooper can't help but go down after that. He's a resilient player, but this will sideline him.
Second down, 1 man back. Looking for room, ground to a halt at the 33.
Picked up 12 yards on the play. First down, Legends.
Jerry Rice is all by himself, and he'll take advantage of it. Easy catch.
Nice catch, Peter, and his stats reflect that.
Definitely, Dan. He's now got 108 yards on 8 catches.
I'm going to be hot today. I can feel it.
You're already hot.
First and 10.
Sanders has his number called on first down. Hands wide left. Hunted down at the 44. That will bring up first down.
This is a great run, Dan. Look at the yards he chews up.
Peter, he had a great jump off the line. He was in fifth gear before the defense could even react.
Motored for some easy yards.
He gets even more yards on the ground. A productive first half, and the second half is shaping up to be just as busy for him.
Until he slows down, there's no reason to change it up.
Second and 11.
incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Joey Browner shows swivel hips and burst to get in position for the denial. That takes instincts and awareness. You just can't coach.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Hammett gets ready to punt it away. The ball and punts it away. The Rhinos offense comes out backed up against their own goal line. They will start at their own 7-yard line. Sayers takes it to his cross-line carry and gains about 3 yards. Cooper was shaken up earlier, and we've gotten a report on his condition. What did they say, Peter?
The team doctor's diagnosis is that he twisted his ankle. They are finishing up putting a brace on him, and it looks like he should be ready to come back in soon.
Well, we'll hope for the best. Thanks, Peter. Sayers picks up the yard on the play, and that brings up third down.
No gain on the play. Third and five from Orlando.
Sacks him for a loss at the 3. It'll be fourth down.
Zen Langston goes in unblocked and nails him to the ground. The O-line should be embarrassed. Watch this. Oh, yeah, sacks don't get much easier than that.
He gets the assist, and he now has one half of a sack for the game. And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Legends enjoying the lead 27-14. Takes the long snap and punts it away. Woodson takes it at the 47. Stopped at the 36.
Rod Woodson racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit. 36 yards.
The Legends start this drive with great field position at the 36-yard line. Sanders catches the heater left sideline, and that's good for 6.
Barry Sanders made the grab back there and then tacked on a few more. Nice play.
Time and time again, he makes a fantastic option of himself coming out of the backfield.
Well, there are some runners that just have a knack for the passing game, and this guy's got it.
Gets the call on second down. Heads out right. Chase down at the 15. First down.
Dan, this is really a tremendous run here. It all starts with getting up to speed extremely fast before the D can really get it together.
The blocking helps him get a little momentum going, and then he's smart enough to make the right running choices downfield.
Oh, he's so dangerous when he busts loose like that. A highlight reel play.
What a run, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, yeah, he's running hard, and up to now, he's got 197 yards on 27 carries.
Connell pulls to the right side, and that's good for six.
John Elway made a nice throw there, got it right past the defender. Again, he uses the middle of the field to advance the football. And, Dan, why not?
Well, they found some seams, some crease right in the middle, and, well, they feel they can take advantage of it at any time. Sanders takes his eighth carry and makes up a couple.
Before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That's his third tackle of the game. With a 23-yarder, and this one is up and in.
Chris Nedney puts in an easy short one. A clean kick, no worries.
That's his third field goal of the day, and giving your team 9 points is nothing to sneeze at.
Well, unless those 9 points are covered by pollen.
Watch it.
Sorry, that makes no sense.
All right, fine. It's a boomer down the field. Sayles hounds it in the end zone for a touchback. A flag is thrown on the play. Let's see what it is.
Holding, number 88, receiving team, half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. First down.
Bobby Whalen clearly held his man back there. Offensive holding was the right call.
The Rhinos have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive that starts at their own 10-yard line. Aiden throws the pass, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Ronnie Lott anticipated the trajectory of that pass and stuck his hand in at the last moment. Great play.
You know, Peter, if this were volleyball, that would have been the defense's sixth spike of the match.
Yeah, the O keeps setting it up and the D keeps sending it back.
Go, Tom.
Second and 10. Ball up at 10 yards.
We'll get the carry on second down and the field. Finally drop at the 22. First down.
Dale Sayers keeps ahead of his tacklers here with a nice juke move. All they have to do is bite for a second, and he's gone. You can't coach that.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
Great execution.
First and 10.
His left tackle and picks up a couple.
7. From Carolina, 24 yards.
Coverage incomplete.
Ronnie Lott didn't get all the way positioned for the interception, but still managed to graze the ball with his fingertips.
That's the second time he slapped that ball out of there.
Excellent read and reaction skills make him a nightmare to try and get the ball past.
Third down, 7 yards to go.
24 yards.
Throws this one. At the 33, and he stopped right there. First down.
Troy Aikman had only one spot where he could put the football, Dan, and that's right where it goes.
Now watch how he sneaks this ball past multiple defenders.
Yeah, it takes a considerable amount of poise and confidence to execute a play like this.
You have to respect this offensive game plan. That was their third connection downfield today, Peter.
Yep, the coaches must have found a weak spot in that secondary.
The 33.
Mike Singletary read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
He's done his part defensively, and now he's racked up his 10th tackle.
Dan, it's all about closing speed at the linebacker position, and he's got it.
Sayers gets the toss and runs into traffic. Stop at the 33. We have a flag on the play. Let's listen to the call.
Holding, number 80, offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, second down.
Henry Ellen held his man on that play, and hey, you can't do that. That was offensive holding any day of the week.
Yeah, that's what I like to see.
Hell yeah, brother!
All right.
Second and 21 from Carolina, 23 yards.
Sayers grabs the run and loses yards on that one.
Rex Williams got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
That's going to be the defense's third stop in a row for a loss.
Yeah, talk about executing. They didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage. Ron Hurd let his man get some yards on this play, but then he stopped him before the marker. Check it out. Yeah, he saved the play by tackling him before the markers. Otherwise, who knows how far he would have gotten.
That's his third tackle of the game. Filipovic lines up for the punt.
It's left of the punt. Woodson is deep to receive.
Filipovic gets the ball and punts it away. Woodson fields the punt at the 19. Ground to a halt at the 22. The Legends will start this drive at their own 22-yard line. Gets the ball and heads left. Jukes! Finally stopped at the 33. It will be first down.
Barry Sanders makes a great run here, but the design run is far from foolproof.
It's risky, but it's a lot easier when you've got such great blocking up front.
Yeah, you don't want your quarterback smashing and bashing for yards. You want him to have a smooth ride all the way.
What a run, Peter, and his numbers are adding up.
Adding up to one big number. Up to now, he's got 211 yards on 30 carries.
For seven.
Sanders with the carry. Gain of seven on the play. Short with the tackle. Second and five from the legend, Woody Allen.
Sanders will lose four on the play, and that brings up third down.
Big one, boys. We need to stop.
Pipe it up. Pipe it up.
Third down and four wideouts in the game. Wood makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. It'll be fourth down.
Willie Wood gets a hand on this one. Right there. That's how you play D.
Hammock gets ready to punt it away. Takes the snap and hits a beauty. Taylor fields the deep punt at the 18. Stop at the 23.
You guys don't want to deal with me? Open field.
The Rhinos had their last drive stalled at the tail end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 23-yard line. Coleman takes the hit in the backfield at the 19.
With the carry. Coleman with the tackle. Loss of 4 yards on the play.
Craig Coleman keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch. Pow! Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Peter, they put an end to that play well in the backfield, and they had a real good read on that.
Yeah, it all starts with the guys up front, Dan, and then everybody follows.
Second down coming up. Picks up one on the play.
Will Sayers stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Number 68 will be credited with the tackle. It'll be fourth down.
Troy Aikman tried to conjure up a little magic out of the busted play with the scramble, but the defense wasn't tricked.
Filipovic lines up to punt after the three and out.
Woodson with deep to receive.
Filipovic takes the long snap and hits a beauty. Woodson fields it to the 29. Great screen, locked down at the 37.
Rod Woodson returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
We have to make a statement on this series.
Let's go.
First and 10. From the Legend, 37 yards.
And that will bring up second down.
A pickup of 4 yards on the play. Frazier with the tackle. Second and 6.
Gets the call again, and he takes it to the field, hunted down at the 48. It will be first down.
Nothing to sneeze at with that game, Dan. These guys are the complete rushing package, and they'll run it on you all day if you let them.
Again, he gets the ball, and they have stuck by the run all game. Peter, why so run heavy up to now?
Well, it's worked, simple as that. If they can't come up with an answer, keep running it down their throat.
We gotta start putting up a better fight.
Let's tough it up.
Go, go.
First and 10.
And that brings up second down.
A pickup of 4 yards on the play. Wood credited with the tackle. Second and 5.
Look alive on this one.
Legends, 44-yarder.
Gets yet another carry for the day and gets past the line. Stop at the 41.
This kind of pickup should be no problem for us.
Convert the third down. It'll be fourth down.
Tiki Short brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That's his third tackle of the game. Fourth down, and they're going for it. Picks up 6 on the play, and they get past the markers and convert the fourth down.
Injury on the field.
It looks like we have an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you.
Vernon Hubbard goes down on this play. Ouch, man, that cannot feel good.
First down, and this is the 7th play of the drive. Sanders gets the call for the first down. The Rhinos take their first time off. Second down. The clock is stopped at 1:52.
Billy Wood rattles the ball carrier's cage there, so much so that the football comes loose. And then since he isn't the one who just got his bell rung, he's alert enough to recover the fumble.
Peter, there are many ways you can start a drive, but a turnover is not one of them.
No, definitely not. That was a big-time play.
The Rhinos start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 1:48. Taylor makes the catch out to the left, and the clock continues to wind down. Second down, and the clock is now at 1:41. Throws a bullet. It's caught at the 35. First down, one man down. Eller falls in the pass and is past the first with daylight. 15. And the Rhinos take a timeout. That's their second.
We gotta stop the passing game.
The legend.
Aikman fires this one over the middle and it's caught for a touchdown.
Let's get more. Come on.
Jamie Lyman has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
This is a take-no-prisoners kind of guy when he is in the red zone.
Oh, after piling up some good yardage on the bay, he makes a big play here for a score.
It looks like they're going for two.
More than one way to get a two-point conversion, and this is the basic good route and a good catch. Nice play.
Sader pooches it. Lee collects it.
Happen on this onside. It comes his way and then gets his hands around it to put the offense out on the field. Great work by this hands team.
They don't get possession back, but you know, I still think the onside kick was the right play there. How about you?
No question about it, my friend. They've already won it, Dan. If they sit on the ball, the clock will tick away and end it. That last timeout that the D has doesn't really amount to anything.
Devin.
The Rhino. All the timeout.
Takes a knee, and the clock will tick down.
Well, that loss will bring up third down, but they can't be too worried about it. They're still eating up the clock. Second to snap this one and take as much time as possible off the clock here.
Devlin takes a knee
And that will do it.
Dan, I want to point out something on that last play. Did you notice the job he did in letting the play clock wind all the way down before snapping the ball? That's good clock management.
And that is going to do it for this one. The Legends come out on top 30-22. With this one in the books, let's take a look back at some of the action. So, the ball game is over. Let's take a quick look back at how it went with our post-game show. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Sanders on the carry here as they work the ground game, and this is a nice run. Unfortunately, they could not capitalize on the play. The Rhinos back at it after their D made a stop in the red zone. Ellard came up with a huge play here as they cover a lot of real estate on this one. A 76-yard touchdown for the home team. Answering right back, the Legends ahead by six. Elway would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. They move ahead by 13. The Rhinos still midway through the third quarter. Aikman went to work on third down and he was able to find his man. Unfortunately, the drive stopped shortly afterwards and they had to punt it away. The Rhinos trailing 27-14. Sanders would get up ahead of steam, and then it was clear sailing from here. That set up an easy 24-yard field goal. The Legends now up by 16. Late into the fourth quarter, this time at the 24. Wynn would snuff out a drive on this one as he's there to recover the fumble. Still late in the fourth quarter, the Rhinos down by 16. Ellard emerged as a real weapon as he pulled one in here. And that's how we'll round this one out. The Legends edge out a win 30-22. And here's your 2K Sports Player of the Game.
Barry Sanders elevated his game like he always does. Well, they put the game on his legs, Dan, and he managed to find his way through holes big and small all game en route to a big rushing performance. And that performance led his team to victory.
For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.